convocation address to the gathering.
सरकार में मंत्री श्री नक्का आनंद बाबू, केंद्र सरकार में मानव संसाधन विकास मंत्रालय का सचिव श्री आर सुब्रमण्यम, स्कूल ऑफ प्लानिंग आर्किटेक्चर बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर्स का अध्यक्ष श्रीमती श्री वृंदा सोमैया और प्रोफेसर मीनाक्षी जैन, डॉक्टर नटराज क्रांति, माय डियर graduates who are all getting graduated today, the students, their parents, faculty members and friends, we have all come here to this meeting. मैं सचमुच में बहुत आनंद महसूस कर रहा हूं. कारण क्या है, ये आंध्र प्रदेश का राजधानी अमरावती या विजयवाड़ा में ये पहली कॉन्वोकेशन है जिसमें नेशनल लेवल स्टूडेंट्स सब लोग आज यहां डिग्री का पात्र हो रहे. ये मेरा स्वप्न था, जो आंध्र प्रदेश जो कंबाइंड थे पहले, जहां सभी यूनिवर्सिटीज, इंस्टीट्यूशन, साइंस एंड रिसर्च सेंटर्स, प्रेस्टिजियस सेंट्रल इंस्टीट्यूशंस, बिजनेस स्कूल्स, काफी सब कुछ थे. मगर जब आंध्र प्रदेश अलग हो गया, ये हमारा स्वप्न था, ऐसी संस्था इस प्रदेश में भी, इस पार्ट में भी होना चाहिए. ये स्वप्न आज साकार हो रहे. स्कूल ऑफ प्लानिंग एंड आर्किटेक्चर का कॉन्वोकेशन के द्वारा इस स्वप्न का साकार हो रहा है. इसलिए मैंने कहा, आई एम वेरी हैप्पी इन माय हार्ट ऑफ हार्ट्स. दिस इज द प्लेस वेयर आई मूव्ड ड्यूरिंग माय यंगर डेज एज अ स्टूडेंट, पार्टिसिपेट इन मेनी ऑफ द एजिटेशंस and also movements. So when I see here this good thing, convocation happening here, and I find students from different parts of the country are getting graduated from this prestigious school of planning and architecture, I feel really delighted. And I am further delighted to address and share my thoughts with all of you on the occasion of the third convocation of the school of planning and architecture, Vijayawada, Institute of National Importance under the Ministry of Human Resource Development of the Government of India. I am equally happy that an iconic building has come in Vijayawada, then I could inaugurate it in the morning before coming over here in Vijayawada itself. This building, this institute was sanctioned in 2008. 2014 onwards, when I was in the government, I was regularly visiting that campus, holding discussions with the HRD officials, with my CPWD Urban Development, for which I was the minister, and also with the finance ministry with regard to release of money, and also reviewing it with the local authorities. And finally, it has come now. It has come up very beautiful. I am sure this beautiful building will be filled up with the beautiful architectures, students in the coming days to come. And beauty and duty, if it is combined, it will become mighty. I hope you will do your duty in the coming days. I congratulate all the graduates who have crossed an important milestone in their career and are awaiting a brighter career. This convocation is special as it coincides with the 10th anniversary of the opening of the School of Planning and Architecture. In the last 10 years, the SPAV has worked a long and commendable path. In 2008, it started from the temporary buildings in Acharya Nagarjuna University. As it extended its horizon and started offering three PG programs and doctoral programs, it moved to hired premises in Nedumaruru. Now it stands on its own and is offering five PG programs, two bachelor programs and also doctoral programs. I congratulate the leadership of the SPAV for the rapid strides made by the institution. I would like to congratulate all the graduates at the bachelor's and master's level and their parents for achieving this important milestone in their careers. I also express my appreciation to the faculty, the director and the administration. I would like the faculty and staff of the school to keep up the high standards of education and research and continue to produce batches of finest professionals needed for our country in the field of architecture and planning. SPA Vijayawada is in the same league as it is the second generation of IITs and NITs. It is important that the institution sets its new benchmarks, high standards, and creates its own brand. Vijayawada is now a seat of exciting transformation as the new capital of the Andhra Pradesh. Thus, SPA Vijayawada gets to witness and participate in the development of the new capital, both geographically and intellectually. It is indeed a great opportunity for students of SPA Vijayawada to observe, study, and contribute suitably to the developmental process. I am happy to learn that the students and staff of SPA Vijayawada have documented the heritage town of Amravati last year, and that research is in progress to make available credible data of the heritage town in the vicinity of which the new capital is shaping up. I am also delighted to know that SPA Vijayawada closely networked with the key research and education institutions of this region and is offering its research, consultancy and advocacy services to the government of Andhra Pradesh in setting up the new capital of Amravati. Dear brothers and sisters, the role of education institutions of excellence, which shape young minds of our country in the disciplines of architecture and planning, is of the immense value and significance. This is because of the role architects and planners in the 21st century is not limited to merely designing and giving a shape to human settlements and buildings. They have to innovate and create to meet the requirements of the fast-changing world in which digital technologies are playing a very important, pivotal role in shaping every aspect of life. Remember, we are living in an era of LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization. The entire globe has become a small village. What is happening here in Vijayawada is known in Vietnam, Vienna, Vietnam and other places in few minutes. What is happening in Andhra is known in America in few minutes. What is happening there is known to us. So you have challenges, you have competition, but at the same time you have great opportunities also. Today the watchwords for everybody are environmental protection and sustainability. This is particularly important for the professionals involved in designing new buildings. The need of the hour is to promote eco-friendly green buildings which use less water and optimize energy and take full advantage of digital technology to build smart buildings with automated operations. To address the phenomena of rapid urbanization and moderate the effects of the migration to urban areas, one must evolve ways to augment that infrastructure and facilities available in the rural and peri-urban areas. This process of urbanization has become irreversible. You can't change it, whether you like it or not, because education, employment, entertainment, economic upliftment, and also enhanced medical facilities, they are all available in cities. So people are coming from rural areas to urban areas. I also say in a lighter movement, even I migrated from rural development to urban development as minister earlier in rural development, then became minister in urban development. Of course, I am no more in government, no more in politics. I have retired from politics but not tired from public life. That's why I am here. We must all focus our attention to have the facilities that are required for our civilization, both in urban areas as well as in rural areas. The rapid urbanization and moderate the effects of migration to urban areas, one must evolve ways to augment and infrastructure facilities available in the rural and peri-urban areas also. In the process of doing so, there is a need to amalgamate tradition and technology to improve the built environment and also work towards sustainable development. That's why I say, preserve your culture. Nature, culture, together for better future through your architecture. This is my advice to all of you. Nature is very vital. We must love and live with the nature. We have played with the nature. Nature is showing its fury on us now. See what is happening in Kerala. What happened in Visakhapatnam. What happened earlier in Chennai. All these natural calamities happening in different parts of the globe. Why? Because we have played with the nature. We must really seriously rethink and introspect what is it we have done. So we must again reinvent and revisit, rethink and must go back to our roots and preserve the nature. Preserve the nature together with the culture for a better future through your architecture. That is the need of the hour. Because the way the planning and architecture, they go hand in hand. Planning is very vital. What is the population of the city? What is the population going to be in another 20 years, 30 years? What are the requirements now? What will be the future requirements? What are the challenges? What are the few challenges, new challenges that are going to come? You must think about all and evaluate them. And also you must also go for integrated planning. The governor was just mentioning about the high-rise buildings. Firefighting, are we taking care of the same? Then green buildings, how to preserve energy? Then how to conserve water? Rainwater harvesting must be part of architecture. Green must also be part of architecture. And then recycle, reuse of the water is also should be part of your architecture and your planning. And then, as I told you, greenery should be part of your architecture. Without greenery, no building should come. Because these are the nature's gifts to the humanity. But unfortunately, we have successfully destroyed all our forests and now we are trying to plant the trees. That's the biggest disservice we have done to the future generations. So now time has come. I'm happy the central government, state governments and other local bodies, they're all focusing now on Swachh Bharat. They're all out thinking on clean and green. These are very much essential. And architectures, you have a responsibility to keep and preserve our culture. Indian culture, Indian heritage, Indian civilization, which is there from times immemorial, is an ideal civilization. You have Roman, you have Greek, you have Athens, you have Egypt, you have other civilizations also. But where do they stand as on now? Where do we stand, India? Indian civilization is becoming more vibrant because we believe in Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. We believe in Vasudhaika Kutumbam. We want to live in harmony with the nature along with every creature. This has to be kept in mind while planning our cities, while planning our buildings and also drawing our architecture. This is very vital for our future. Please remember these things. It is very important for sustainable development. It is important to create amenities in rural areas that are on par with urban areas. At the same time, it should be ensured that rural areas are not turned into concrete jungles, and there should be a perfect blend of modernity and tradition. I have been to Barcelona some time back as urban development minister to attend the Smart City Conference. I was just thinking Barcelona must be all high-rise. When I landed there and about to land, I saw a row of houses in similar fashion. I visited the mayor's house, the mayor's bungalow, and then to my surprise I found it's not high-rise, it's normal. Because they say they want to preserve their culture, they want to preserve their heritage. So Indian architects also must keep this in mind. We have to preserve our culture, our heritage, which is time-tested. And plan accordingly. I am sure that your learning in this institution must have inculcated the right qualities in you to be dynamic and responsible professionals. Dear students, India is the fastest growing economy and all set to become the third largest economy in the world in the next 15-20 years. Plenty of opportunities are awaiting you. Entire world economy is slowing down, but India is on the move. That's our fortune. It's not me saying, the World Bank, the World Economic Forum, the ADB, the Moody ratings, not Modi ratings, Moody ratings also. Everything confirms that India is on the move. We are unstoppable because this land, this air, this water, these people, these generations, these jinns, they have something special in them. Everyone has got some talent. What is required is little upgradation, little skill development so that you can unleash the forces of growth and the vision and thinking in everybody. That is what is required. These institutions, they must focus on that. India, you know, right from Susruta to Charaka to Aryabhatta to all other people in every field of life, walk of life, Indians, they excel. I'm not going into those details because I don't have that much time and it's convocation, I'm aware of it. Otherwise, India excelled. Just now the governor was mentioning about Adharmala Veda, our Shastras. They are all, what is Shastras? They are full of knowledge. Unfortunately, because of colonial rule, we have changed our minds. The outsiders came here, ruled us, ruined us, looted us and cheated us also, cheated our minds also. That's the problem. We must think that we are Indians. We must feel proud that we are Bharatiyas. We must learn from our Shastras and our Vedas and our literature that is available to us. Make study and research and then think, of course. We want to be modern, undoubtedly. Modern do not mean not only in dress, height, weight, coat, suit, boot, hat. Someone asked me, sir, now you have become vice president. What about the dress? I said, what? They said, sir, dress. Normally, vice president means bandhgala, coat, suit, boot. I said, no change of dress, only change of address. From Abdul Kalam Road to Maulana Azad Road. This is not change of dress. So-called modernity is not going to add to your stature, your work, your caliber, your capacity, your conduct. That will enhance the credibility of the institution you are leading or the personality. So, dear students, remember the past. Plan for the future. This is the advice. I was so impressed by the brief address given by the governor. He made very, very good points. As I told you, plenty of opportunities are awaiting you. I was minister earlier in urban development. 35 to 40 ambassadors, they came and met me. They all want to invest in India. Smart cities, Amrut cities, housing for all. Lot of programs are awaiting. Lot of programs are there. Lot of opportunities are there. And the demand is so much for the architects. So the architects really should focus on that. And moreover, an architect means, as I told you, you are the architects of the future of India. The new India. How do you create new India? It is your responsibility. The Prime Minister is talking of new India. The Prime Minister gave a three-line advice. He said reform, perform and transform. You have fortunately a lot of chief ministers who have got vision. You have a chief minister here who has a vision for the future of the state. So these visionaries, visions of the chief minister, the prime minister, and the past history and culture and heritage, if you combine all these together, we, as I told you, there are a lot of opportunities awaiting you. And you have inherent talent also. Combine all of them, then you will excel. You should become trendsetters in your field and become partners in India's growth story. As you all aware, techniques of designing of buildings and planning of cities have evolved over the years and play a major role in creating a healthy and prosperous societies. The leading scientific universities of the world are not just focused on teaching, but are intent on becoming the very nerve centers of innovation and incubation of appropriate technology that can reach and touch the lives of masses in every way. You need to have inclusive growth in your planning. In your focus, the last man in the queue also should be kept in mind. The poorest of the poor also has to be kept in mind. And we must design and come up with such plans. I urge all our students and faculty and the graduates to strive towards research and innovation that can really make our cities happier and safer and our buildings greener and affordable. I would like to advise you all, please remember, we have inherited a great culture, great heritage, and then a great responsibility is awaiting us. And as I told you, everyone must remember the culture, must remember five things. One, mother, the mother who has given you the beautiful birth. Two, the native place, Janma Bhumi, the place where you are born. Third, mother tongue, the language that has come from mother's womb. The mother tongue may be Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, Malayali, Marathi, Punjabi, Assami, Bhojpuri, Dogri, Kashmiri, whatever it is. Should never, never forget your mother tongue. At home, you must converse in your mother tongue only. And then motherland, the country to which you belong to. Attack to Katak, Kanyakuma to Kashmir. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, India is one. We are one nation, one people, one country. That feeling should be there in everybody. We may have different languages. Alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. vividata me ekata bharat ka visheshata, that is the beauty of this great land. So keep that in mind. And then guru, the guru who taught you, he or she should never be forgotten. So mother, janmabhumi, mother tongue, motherland and guru, these five things should be remembered by one and all. This mother tongue is very important because bhasha aur bhavana ek saath chalta hai. English, I am not against. You must learn English, you must learn French, you must learn Russian, Chinese, so many. I have no problem. You must also learn Hindi. I realized the importance of Hindi after I reached Delhi. When a student, I participated in anti-Hindi agitation without knowing what it is. Later I realized, Hindi ke bina Hindustan mein aage badhna sambhav nahi hai. But at the same time, as I told you, the original ideas will come in your mother tongue. So, please, this colonial mindset, we have to come out of it. We must think in our own language and try to express to the, because you will be able to articulate better. You say Amma, it comes from Antaral, inside. You say Mummy, it comes from here. Go home, stay in your hostel today evening, and then practice what the Uparashtrapati has said. Amma, Mummy. What is this Mummy, Dummy, Daddy, Biddy? Why can't we respect our language? Friends, I have been receiving foreign delegates, presidents, vice president, and I have been attending parties given by the Prime Minister and President for other dignitaries. Every reader who is coming from outside, they are not speaking in English, though they know English. They are speaking in their mother tongue and somebody is there sitting to translate. I asked Sushma Swaraj, are they not aware of English? Then he said, no, everybody knows, but they don't self-respect. They want to speak in their own mother tongue. We Indians, because we are ruled by these people, and we have developed that weakness. So please remember to always respect this thing. It's so much advancement have come, technology advancement have come. No problem. Okay, good. Google. Now, you ask any child anything, they don't apply their mind. They go Google. Google. Okay, Google is good, but Google can never replace Guru. Remember Guru who has given you this basic education. This is my advice to all of you. And then as I told you in the beginning, love and live with the nature, nature, culture, for a better future through architecture. This is my advice to all of you. Once again, congratulate you, all of you, wholeheartedly and sincerely. Work hard to become something in life. Dr. Kalam has said, aim high, dream high. Simply dreaming and aiming alone will not suffice. You have to work hard. If you work hard, you can excel in your field, irrespective of your past, irrespective of your family. If you work hard, if you aim high and dream high, you will definitely excel. That is the life of India. So, my dear young friends, I wish you all the best. And then, God bless you all. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.